Okay, I had to stop the fan because otherwise it would make too much noise because it's just beside the camera. But it's so hot. Every summer I say the same thing, but every summer it's so hot in Los Angeles. Okay, it has been a while since I didn't talk to you directly in front of the camera, just like that. I don't know why, actually. Maybe because the videos I was doing were better by filming what I was doing, probably. But I'm glad to be here, actually. It's like if I hadn't seen a friend since a very long time. It's a little that, actually. I didn't listen to a lot of music lately, except in my car, but in my car it's not the same. I don't know why I didn't listen to music. I was focused on boring things, and I think that I didn't want to associate music to what I was doing, probably. And the news were not the best. I lost my grandmother. After my father, it made a lot, and my friend Ron is not very good also, so he's not fine. So all that was a little too much, and maybe I didn't want to associate music to that, especially Ron is a specialist of music, and he was not interested in music lately, what is kind of worrying, because he basically lives for music. Anyway, I was doing my work, my usual work. I sell a lot of things on internet. I have an online shop. Actually, I have two online shops, but one which works better than the other. I was sorting a lot of things, actually things which belong to Ron's mother, because he asked me like 3 years ago, I think, yes, to help him sell his mother's stuff, and there was so much that I still have some. And she used to collect the Beatrix Potter figures. I don't know if you know that. It's an English woman who was drawing animals then, and she was writing books also, I think, but stories about animals, a little like La Fontaine in France, kind of little story for children, I suppose. And actually then were created a lot of figurines which had the look of her little animals. They all have names, and well, it's not my thing to collect figurines, that's not my thing, but I find Beatrix Potter rather interesting. And I came across this brochure in Ron's mother's stuff, and I started reading. So you see, that was Beatrix Potter, and I was reading about all these animals, and especially about the story of this woman. Actually, I think she was living in the Lake District. So when she became famous, because I think she became famous while she was alive, and she was selling books, and all the money that she earned, she used that money to preserve the Lake District. So when I hear Lake District, it makes me think of Marcolis, of course, because he used to, I don't know if he still does, but he used to go there for vacation. It seems to be very beautiful. I hope one day I will go there to visit. It was funny because they are explaining in this little brochure that this woman, when she was a child, she was taking all her animals with her when they were traveling with her parents and her family. And it made me laugh because I always traveled with my animals, cats, dogs, and always taking them everywhere I go. This little thing made me laugh, and I thought of Marcolis, who always had animals in his songs, in his life too, because when he stopped touring, I know he had a farm in England, somewhere in England. I read that he had like 16, I'm not sure. I read that he had a lot of animals, pets, but not only farm animals. I was thinking it's funny because it's talking about animals, it's talking about Lake District, and suddenly I realized that I talked about Marcolis, I talked about Tok Tok, and I never talked about the animals. And the animals is basically what characterizes Tok Tok and Marcolis. So I thought, I forgot something. So you see, I forgot something. So I thought I should do a video about the animals. So you must know that in the 80s, when I started listening to Tok Tok, I was listening to the album It's My Life mostly, and there are a lot of sounds of animals on the record and the album, and I never thought about that. For me it was obvious, it was like, yes, it's like that, they are about animals, you know, and I didn't even wonder why. Maybe because I was into animals myself, so for me it was completely normal. And I even used the sound of the animals, of the elephant, on my answering machine at home. What I mean is that I was playing the record while I was recording the message, and we could hear the animals, and I was saying, yes, you are at Yale. And people, when they were hearing the elephant and all these animals, they knew that they were at my home, because I was the kind of person loving animals, so nothing surprising about that. So for me it was not only about the music, it was also about this animal aspect, because I recognized myself in that. It's funny that I didn't talk about that, about the animals before. So that is something which was very familiar in the 80s for me. And now I realize that if you look at many clip videos by Tok Tok, there are a lot of animals. It's My Life. You can see that also on Life's What You Make It. If you look at the cover, the jacket of the records, there are always animals on the jacket. The artist James March, who made the jacket, the cover of the records, it's always animals. When we see animals, we know it's about Tok Tok or Marcolis. If you look at the Marcolis solo album, there is also an animal on the cover. Well, the animal looks a little dead to me, but anyway, it's still an animal. So I started wondering why the animals, because they love animals. And then by thinking of the animals, it made me think of the band, the Animals, of the 60s and more. And suddenly I realized that the Animals had a song named It's My Life. It's my life and I do what I want. Da, da, da. So I thought, wow, that is a strange coincidence. Did Marcolis do that purposely? And then I realized that there was another song which had the same title. I noted it. Yes, it's Inside Looking Out. So it's maybe a coincidence. Maybe it was made randomly, I don't know. But I'm wondering if Marcolis didn't go into the animals to remind the animals, the band. I was wondering. I also heard several stories about It's My Life. Originally, the story was that they went to the London Zoo and they thought that they were going to record the animals just like that, but they recorded actually the voices of the people who were there and talking about ice cream and things like that. And so they couldn't use the recording of the animals because of all the voices and all the people talking around. So I read that they had to go back in the night or at a moment where there was nobody to record the sounds, but I read somewhere else that they had actually to use machine to create the noise of animals or maybe sounds that they bought. I don't know. Or maybe they went to the zoo when there was nobody and they sampled the sound and they used the machine. So it's a mix of the two possibilities. And maybe they did it like that. So I don't know exactly how the animals were made on It's My Life. I discovered also something about Eric Burdon, the singer of the Animals. I read somewhere he was saying that he was changing of band all the time to live a new experience. Actually, he was belonging to a band and then he changed of band and then he changed of band again and he was doing very different things every time. Does it remind you someone? And Mark Hollis did the same. He changed of style on each album by still remaining Mark Hollis and Tok Tok, which is incredible. And even when he made the Mark Hollis solo album, it was not Tok Tok anymore, but it was completely different, but still we could recognize Mark Hollis. Which means that he has his own style, which can travel from one album to the other in different styles. It's kind of, there is a word for that. I will write it here if I find. He managed to have his own style. The Animals is something which is coming back all the time. So now I am wondering if it's not linked to the Animals, the band. I am wondering. If you have any idea on the subject, please let me know. I would be very curious. I searched on internet and I found nothing relevant about that, except the fact that there was a lot of animals around, including in Mark Hollis' farm in the country years later. So the other day I was reading someone wrote on Instagram, someone wrote, if you want to be happy, don't live in the past and don't spend your time looking at what other people are doing. At first I thought, oh, it's right. But then I suddenly realized that I was looking in the past by doing this Mark Hollis and Tok Tok video. And I was looking at what someone was doing then. But I think that it was not said in that direction. I mean, if you spend your life regretting the past, and if you spend your life comparing yourself to someone else, then you are not going to be happy. I think that's what they meant. Because I think also that we can understand the present if we know what happened before, if we acknowledge our history. And I think that Mark Hollis as Tok Tok are a part of our musical history and a very important part in mine, actually. So I think it's right to look at what they were doing, especially in what spirit. Then I'm not comparing myself to Mark Hollis. Has nothing to do. First, I'm a woman, he's a man, he was a star, I'm not. And I don't say that like, I'm not a star, I don't care about being a star. I grew up with a star in my home, it was quite enough, thank you. So that's not the problem, absolutely not. But you see, I am still finding things to talk about. It's rather hard because it's in the past. So there are limited quantities of stories to tell. I can't invent things just for the sake of doing a video. So I said a lot of things. I talked about a lot of subjects, articles, interviews, musics, videos, spirit, how the music was made, how Mark Hollis was, all that which is fascinating. But I need some more material to continue, you know. Of course, there is still my painting. I will talk about it when it's time to talk about it. Right now, it's not time to talk about it. But beside my painting, which is rather personal to me, talking purely about Marcolis and Tok Tok, I really need some more subjects and things to talk about. So if Marcolis is watching, please do something so I will have something to talk about. No, because, you know, I don't want to repeat myself and always say the same thing, and I'm not going to do videos just where I show pictures of Marcolis. For me, that's not the point of my videos. I'm not saying anything about these kinds of videos. Some people like watching these kinds of videos, but it's not the purpose of mine, of my videos. On my videos, I really want to exchange with you about a specific subject, a theme related to Marcolis and Tok Tok, which would be relevant, interesting enough, which brings something new in the conversation, and so you can answer or comment or ask a question or add something. But now it starts being hard because it makes 2 years and a half. In November it will be 3 years of Marcolis and Tok Tok videos, and I feel like a little searching for interesting subjects, and I'm lacking of subjects. So if you have any idea, if there is something specific that you want, if it fits with my videos, I would be glad to do it. Okay, I think that I'm going to leave you here. Please think about the animal things. I have right now 3 cats in my house who are obviously sleeping, because usually they disturb me when I'm filming. But today, of course, as I'm talking about animals, they are AWOL. I don't know where they are. They are probably sleeping because of the heat. She doesn't like me to take her, and now I have hair everywhere. Okay, oh, it's too hot. Next video, I don't know. I'm navigating between my minimalist journey and my art and craft and all my paperwork. I'm still on that and it's boring. It will be one or the other, or decluttering or arts and craft, or maybe something about my painting. Anyway, if you have any subject to talk about, please let me know, and I will see you very soon. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.